A lot of people were involved in making the Breeders' Crown work. Kenny Rice is down in the winner's circle, and here's Kenny.
Thank you, Sharon. With me, the executive director of this Breeders' Crown Series, Tom Charters. Tom, we started this October 5th at the Red Mile in Lexington for the two-year-olds. Wrapping it up here tonight, it has been a great series.
What a great series. We had great racing. I think we had five divisional champions we showed the folks. I think we've shown them a horse in the year in Fancy Crown. It's just been super. It's better than we ever expected, I think.
And also expansion plan for next year when the age trotters and pacers get involved.
We had an age trot, an age pace. You'll get to see the free-for-all stars across North America. I think it'll really complement the program.
Looking back on it all, some classic races too, I think we can also say, when you think back to especially Annihilator and Dragon's Lair matchup.
Well, that was, I think, the greatest race of the year, that first elimination heat this year. Jeff will forgive me. He'll say the second heat was, but this race here tonight was a super confrontation, and we saw a horse who was two-year-old trotter of the year, and in some question in some people's minds, come back and prove he's the best three-year-old trotter in the country. He's earned well over $1,200,000. I don't think anybody will dispute it this year.
Tom Charters, been a pleasure working with you. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Kenny.
Tom Charters, the executive director of this Breeders' Crown Series. Sharon?
One more winner, Michael Kalesa of Chicago, the grand prize winner of the Breeders' Crown Sweepstakes, made his entry at Maywood Park in Chicago.